So this is environment. We have some 15 to 16 questions on environment. Basically, environment is part of geography only. Okay. So if we want to say how many questions have come in geography, we can merge 6 plus 15, totally 21 questions. That's a good weightage. So you cannot skip geography class. Okay, you can skip polity, you can skip history, but you cannot skip geography. Okay, fine. Let us see what questions we have. The first question goes like this. Which of the following are the reasons or factors for exposure to benzene pollution? D2, I have told you about pollution, air pollution. And now you have to tell me where is benzene pollution. We did not discuss benzene pollution. I agree. But we have discussed air pollution, and somewhere I might have mentioned C6H6, which is benzene. Right? At least you can guess wildly in the sense, roughly you can guess. No need to go into the depth of the question. Roughly, what can be the answer? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, we have D2. D3 can also guess. See, this is a democratic class. I am not here to dictate you like a Hitler. I am here to take your opinion also. This is democracy. This is parliament. You are supposed to speak. We want your opinion also. At least take a wild guess. So Uday Kiran is saying B. Monica is saying C, sir. Lohit is saying C. Sushma is saying C. Sai Lohit is saying C. Not exactly. Not acid rains. Acid rains is when you have formation of acid. Harsha is saying C. U Srikant is saying B. Divya Shri is saying D. Ashok sticking to C. No, I'm not asking you to choose the options here. I'm asking you to, you know, tell which one might be true. Okay, fine. You have chosen C. That means 1, 3, 4. Let us see first what is benzene. So benzene, as you know, is a, you know, the hexavalent structure that is C6H6. Right? Carbon has 4 vacancy. 1, 2, 3, 4. And 4 bonds are made with, you know, carbon and hydrogen. Now, what is its importance? You have the benzene pollution that is released from motor vehicles, paints, liquids, detergents, wood stains, plastic pipes. Why this is important? Because if benzene stays in the atmosphere, it's going to cause a lot of problem. Okay, what problem? You can see human hematopoietic function. Hematopoietic means it will cause problem in the circulation of the blood. Okay, may cause anemia. What is anemia? Loss of the RBC, WBC, RBC, platelets we have, red blood cells will be reduced. Infection, bleeding under the skin, dysfunction of brain. Brain is the utmost important, that is the CPU for the civil servants. Others, even if they don't have brain, doesn't matter. But for the civil servants, you require brain. Liver, kidney. Now, that is why it is very important. That's why UPSC is focusing on that. See the options here, and you can easily answer. You can find wood here. Yes, you can find motor vehicle, plastic pipes. Okay, so with that, we have automobile exhaust, wood burning we have seen, wood furniture we have seen, wood. Polyurethane is, you know, like you can say plastic. Okay, so 1, 3, 4, 5. Where do we have 1, 3, 4, 5? You don't have here, you don't have here, you don't have here. So what is the option? D. So what I'm telling you is, even if you don't know the tobacco, whether it is emitting or not emitting benzene, you still can answer this question. That is D. Okay, so this is also a difficult question. Students faced a lot of difficulty in answering this. But, you know, with some amount of analysis like this, you can always answer the question. Fine, let us see the next one. What is advantage of fertigation? Fertigation, okay? When you are writing exam in the 2 hour time span, your brain usually is in the mode of, you know, like Usain Bolt. It is trying to run 100 meters in 9.8 seconds. In that hurry, it will not be able to analyze, but if you truly analyze this, it is a simple question. Okay. So see, fertigation. If I divide fertigation, it will be divided into fertilizer or fert plus gation. What is this saying? It is saying irrigation, ir plus gation. Okay. Chemigation, chemi plus gation. That means if you are applying chemicals in the water, in the liquid form, that is called as chemigation. If you are applying fertilizers in the liquid form, that is called as fertigation. If you are applying water in the form of liquid, of course you will apply in the form of liquid only. You won't throw crystals, right? That is called as irrigation. Fertigation controls the alkalinity of irrigation water possible. Correct. Okay. What is alkalinity? I will explain you. First, see this. Read the second. Efficiency of application of rock phosphate. See the word rock. Rock means it is solid. Okay. Rock phosphate and all other phosphatic fertilizers is possible. Underline the rock phosphate. Increased availability of nutrients to the plants is possible. This is correct. When you are doing fertigation, you can increase the availability of nutrients. Reduction in leaching of chemical is also possible. Okay. So 1 and 3, 3 and 4 we have known. But one, what is one? If you have studied some amount of chemistry in your school days, so it would appear something like this. So this is the alkalinity. Alkalinity means, you know, the alkaline nature, that is base. We have acids, we have base. This is the pH scale. pH means power of hydrogen ions, plus ions. Okay, what is an ion? We will discuss that later. Okay, why it is H plus? It has lost one electron. Now, pH is neutral in case of the drinking water. In the case of blood also, it is almost neutral. It is acidic in lemon juice, acidic in the grape juice, black coffee, black tea is also acidic. That is why when you drink black coffee, you feel more acidic. You immediately will drink something base, okay? Like baking soda, right? కడుపులో అసిడిటీ అయింది అంటే సోడా తాగండి అంట సోడా తెచ్చిస్తారు దట్ ఈస్ బేస్ ఓకే సో వాటర్ షుడ్ నాట్ బి అసిడిక్ ఇఫ్ వాటర్ ఇస్ అసిడిక్ ద ప్లాంట్స్ విల్ నాట్ సర్వైవ్ ఇట్ షుడ్ నైదర్ బి బేస్ ఓకే ఇట్ షుడ్ బి ఇన్ ద న్యూట్రల్ రేంజ్ దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ ద యూపీఎస్సీ ఈస్ ట్రైంగ్ టు ఫోకస్ యూపీఎస్సీ ఈస్ ట్రైంగ్ టు టెల్ యూ దాట్ బై ఫర్టిగేషన్ వీ కెన్ యాక్చువల్లీ సేవ్ the water, the irrigation water from becoming alkaline. So you can see this. Controlling the alkalinity of irrigation water is possible. Yes, it is possible. 1, 3, and 4. But rock phosphate is a solid object, so you cannot, you know, make it in the form of fertigation. What exactly fertigation looks like? We have an image. Let us see. So this is fertigation. You can see there is a in the next year there will be one more question. Drip irrigation is used for fertigation. Yes, correct. This is drip irrigation. We are using fertilizer in the liquid form to the plants. Okay, a very new and expensive method for the farmers. this fertigation process was, you know, identified recently. I mean, it is present in the Western countries where they have innovative techniques. Nowadays, new techniques are coming up in India also for farmers. Correct. Monica is saying rock phosphate is soluble in water. Of course, it is soluble in water. Phosphorus, of course, it is soluble in water. That is how plant is able to take it. Phosphorus cycle, we have discussed phosphorus cycle. Remember that? But you see here, efficient application of rock phosphate is possible. You cannot apply rock phosphate through fertigation. Okay? Getting it? So this is fertigation. Fertilizer applied constant rate from irrigation start to finish, right? So you have all the information here. I have explained you all these things. You can apply to banana. So Monica is saying that then it can be applied by mixing with the water. Actually, see here, he didn't mention you have to mix with the water here. He is saying efficient application of rock phosphate. That is, you are throwing the phosphorus rock, I mean bundles in the sense, phosphorus rocks into the fields directly. He didn't mention the water kind of thing here, right? I hope that is clear. Moreover, if this is a right also, according to you, there is no option like all of the above, right? So that is also a point which has to be thought of. Sir, without water, rock phosphate doesn't give action. Rock, see, phosphorus, you have rocks, you have phosphorus in the rocks. Now, when the rock is here, there is a plant here. Okay. Now, what is the root? What do roots do? Roots usually derive the phosphorus from the rocks and they intake the phosphorus. That is a nutrient, macronutrient. Nitrogen, phosphorus and potash are the macronutrients. You can apply nitrogen. You can apply potash. Through solid form and liquid form. But here in the option, he has not mentioned that water. That's why it is wrong. India's desert national park, which of the statements are correct? Okay, this is an ignored national park because it is very small and rarely people care about this, even the UPSC aspirants. It spreads over two districts. So you can see this is very minute things. No aspirant, even if he has, you know, even if it is Anudeep Durishetty who has scored rank 1, will be able to say this is right or wrong. Unless or until he has worked in that national park. But it is correct. Okay, so Jaisalmer and Barmer are the two districts. I'll show you the image. There is no human habitation inside the park. When it is spreading almost in the two districts, do you think there is no person residing there? Of course, there will be tribals also, right? So some people will be there. Okay, people are not even living Moon or Mars. How can they live in national park? This is wrong. It is one of the natural habitat of great Indian bustard. This is very simple. Third statement, it is correct because you see, desert means it is Rajasthan. Clear? And Rajasthan's national animal bird is the great Indian bustard. It is also found in Karnool district. Rolapadu Wildlife Sanctuary, I told you. Barmer and Jaisalmer are the two districts. Now, this is currently under the Indian Army. BSF, Border Security Force, is bordering the region. And Indian Army is also present there, both of them. You can find, you know, these animals. Okay. So this is the great Indian bustard. It is the heaviest flying bird in the world. It is found in Rollapadu Wildlife Sanctuary, Karera Wildlife Sanctuary, Karera in Madhya Pradesh. Okay. And also in Desert National Park in Rajasthan. It is a very critical, critically endangered bird, and only 100 population, 100, individuals are there in the India as of now. We have to save them. One more point I want to add here is UPSC conducts common exam for the Indian Forest Service and Indian Civil Services. Indian Forest Service requires a good command over all these things. That is why this UPSC guy has, focused more on the birds, animals, okay, lizards, all these things. See, which among the following tiger reserves has largest area under critical tiger habitat? Indian Forest Service officer cannot answer this, but we can answer this by a simple technique. What is the technique? First of all, I have told you to D2 students long ago that there is a national park called Jim Corbett National Park. Jim Corbett National Park was named on Jim Corbett, who was the Imperial Civil Services officer who used to hunt the tigers, which used to kill the man. So Jim Corbett will definitely be not a critical tiger habitat, because there are a lot of tigers there. So this is not the option. Then Sundarbans. In Sundarbans, we have Royal Bengal tiger, white tiger. I have shown you image recently. So Royal Bengal tiger is not the answer, because there are enough Royal Bengal tigers there. So it cannot be considered as critical habitat. Ranthambore National Park is also not the answer. And last one remaining is the Nagarjuna Srishalam, and it is the one which is critical habitat. So how will you find out that? See here, Madhya Pradesh, there are 526 tigers. Assam, there are 190. Uttarakhand, 442. Jim Corbett National Park in Uttarakhand. Tamil Nadu, 264. Kerala, 190. Maharashtra, 312. Karnataka, 524. Can you find Andhra Pradesh there? So Andhra Pradesh is not there. That means in Nagarjuna's, we can arrive at a point that Nagarjuna Srishalam will be having less than the other parks. So we can go for Nagarjuna Srishalam. This is a wild guess, but it will be correct, because the more the tigers, the better the living conditions. The less the tigers, the poorer the living conditions. We are all in South India because living conditions are good here. We are not in Arctic pathetic conditions. Okay. Next one. People usually mug them up, these things. So analysis is required rather than mugging up. So Jim Corbett, you can find here. Then we have Ranthambore in Rajasthan and Madhya Pradesh borders. Nagarjuna Srishalam here. We have another one is the Sundarbans here. Okay, tiger reserves in India. If a particular plant species is there in the Schedule 6 of Wildlife Protection Act, what is the implication? What is the implication? A license is required to cultivate. Such a plant cannot be cultivated under any circumstances. It is a genetically modified crop. Such plant is invasive and harmful to ecosystem. You can eliminate two options here. It is genetically modified. It is not the option, because genetically modified organisms are not placed under Schedule 6 or Wildlife Act. Okay. Such a plant is invasive or harmful. If it is invasive and harmful, why would we place it on Wildlife Act? We will ask the people to, usually cut them down without any hesitation, right? So these two can be wrong. Now what is the remaining? These two are very close. These two are very close, but you have to take a wild guess if you are not aware of the things. If you are aware of the things, you can go for B option. We had a PPT where we have discussed about Wildlife Protection Act. Schedule 6 the plants in the schedule 6 are prohibited from cultivation and planting. We have schedule 1, schedule 2, schedule 3, 4, 5 different animals are there in this, but schedule 6 is for plants. Okay, so that wild guess in the Wildlife Protection Act will help you. What are the advantages and disadvantages of zero tillage? Okay, so zero tillage is a very interesting and, you know, you can say eco-friendly practice, eco-friendly agriculture. What is zero tillage? Zero tillage means you don't do the ploughing. I mean, you don't do the ploughing by using the plough. There are, okay, two bulls. You don't do the ploughing. What will you do then? You will directly sow the crop. What is the use? These are the uses. 1, 2, 3. All of them are the uses. Sowing wheat is possible without burning the residue of the previous crop. Yes, correct. Okay, but it will take somewhat, more time for the seeds to generate. Okay. Without the need of nursery of rice saplings, direct plantation of the paddy seeds in wet soil is possible. It is also correct. Carbon sequestration is also possible. That carbon dioxide can be present, can be stored in the plant itself. If you burn them, what happens? That will release the carbon dioxide into the atmosphere, right? So both, all of them are correct. Zero tillage, you have some options here. You can see this is kind of a presentation. Planting resource kind of approach, okay? Obnoxious weeds can be controlled. Less fuel consumption, shortened, better soil structure, texture, aggregate stability, poor effect of crop residue left over and over the soil, increased soil availability. I can add two more points here. Okay, soil erosion will be decreased. Okay, better nutrients can be supplied to the crop. Right, you need not to have the bulls or ox to dig, to do ploughing. You need not to have the Mahindra tractor, right? That is less capital investment in the agriculture. So this is what I'm saying. He is more focusing on agriculture. What is the meaning? That every student should know what is agriculture. You can see here benefits of conservation, tillage, soil, water, time and money is saved. You need not to have the tractor. Reduced fuel, okay, feeding the biology, snakes will be surviving there. All these things you can. National policy, according to Indian National Policy on Biofuels, which of the following are raw materials for production of biofuels? First, we have to know what is a biofuel. All of you know what is a diesel? All of you know what is petrol? I have discussed this thing with the D3, that is your seniors. I have given them elaborate notes on biofuels. The four generations of biofuels, I have given them notes. So you guys, when there is science and technology class for you, I'll definitely take up this. This was discussed in S&T, not in environment. Okay. Biofuel is a fuel which doesn't emit harmful gases like sulfur dioxide, nitrogen oxides, or methane, or carbon dioxide. Or the emission is very less. Okay. So biofuel is derived from the, seeds of Kaniga antargada, Kaniga, Jatropha. Okay. So cassava is mana Telugu lo emantarante, English lo emantarante, sweet potato antar. దాన్నే కసావా స్వీట్ పొటాటోని బ్రెజిల్లో కసావా అంటారు అలాగే ఉంటుంది సేమ్ ఓకే గంజిగడ్డ వి కాల్ ఇట్ ఓకే ఫర్ దోస్ హూ డోంట్ నో డ్యామేజ్డ్ వీట్ గ్రెయిన్స్ ఎస్ వీటిని ఫర్మెంటేషన్ చేస్తే ఇఫ్ యూ డూ ఫర్మెంటేషన్ ఆఫ్ దీస్ థింగ్స్ వీ కెన్ గెట్ బయోఫ్యూయల్ దెర్ ఇస్ అ పాయింట్ హియర్ యూ కెన్ ప్రొడ్యూస్ బయోఫ్యూయల్ ఫ్రమ్ ఆల్ ద సిక్స్ బట్ ఇండియన్ నేషనల్ బయోఫ్యూయల్ పాలసీ states that only damaged grains can be used for production of biofuels because if you have groundnuts why can't you feed it to the poor why will you use it for the biofuel food security is under threat why you are producing biofuels okay so by that we can say groundnuts is not the answer ante kada ground na daggar seeds unnai ante I can give it to the poor people he can make chutney and prepare and eat it okay if there is horse gram ante enti ulavalu telugulo ulavalu okay horse gram ulava ante ulava charge chestuntam kada why will we produce biofuel 3 and 4 is not the option tell me 3 and 4 where do you find the rest option a okay 1 2 5 6 rotten potatoes sugar beet cassava damaged beet all of them are not so you know fit for consumption that's why so this is first generation second generation third generation fourth generation right you can see sugar beet sugar cane wheat corn but these are you know the one which have been eliminated damaged one getting it wood straw grass waste microalgae micro and microalgae solar to fuel engineered algae genetic engineering ante enti we will discuss that in the science and technology class biofuels you have all this which are biofuels you can produce biofuel in your home also just gather all the kitchen waste from your home and do fermentation for 3-4 months do fermentation there will be you know add water add some chemicals you will get the biofuel in the end it will be collected on the top which of the following statements best describes social cost of carbon divide the word social that means society cost means you are paying the cost for the release of carbon that is it is a long term damage done by CO2 emission in a given year okay this is a simple question because you can eliminate the wrong options and you can see that first statement is fitting well okay so this was where did we find this was asked in a magazine called as Down to Earth magazine which is exclusively printed for geography guys okay geography optional aspirants will read Down to Earth magazine right so what about the other students they have to skip the question or they have to take a wild guess that's it in pretext of India consider the following practices which are eco friendly okay so eco friendly practices all of them are eco friendly crop diversification instead of one crop you can grow many crops legume intensification why legume intensification because it will help in fixing the nitrogen diatomic molecule okay nitrogen is present in the air 79% of the air is filled with the nitrogen but we cannot use of nitrogen I mean in the plants cannot use of nitrogen unless or until there is no nitrogen fixing bacteria rhizophora azoto you know all this bacteria legume intensification correct tensiometer to determine the amount of water in the soil correct vertical farming is famous in Hyderabad also recently a techie guy who was working in software company he left his job and he started vertical farming ante oka there will be a array tray and in this he is growing here spinach on the top of that he is growing coriander on the top of that he is growing pudina perishable goods you know the small scale agriculture. On the top of it, he is going the mirchi, all these things. All of them are options. Correct, Vivek. So you can see these are eco-friendly practices, permaculture, okay, regenerative agriculture, nature farming, organic farming, biodynamic agriculture, ecological agriculture. We will discuss about them when we come to environment. With reference to Indian elephants, consider the following statements. This question was asked on based on a tweet by an IFS officer. He tweeted about Indian elephants. The four statements he tweeted in his tweet, and the same tweet was picked up and put up as a question, right? What did he tweet? One of the guy asked him to talk about elephants, so he tweeted the four statements. First statement is leader of an elephant is always a female, correct. Maximum gestation period can be 22 months, also correct. Elephant can normally go on claying, it is not claying, it is coughing. Means laying the, sorry, giving birth to a child. So 40 years only, no 40 years, it is 60 years. Highest elephant can be seen in Karnataka, not Kerala. So 3 and 4 are wrong. Only 1 and 2 are correct. So this is the elephant. You can imagine a group of elephants, and when there is a baby elephant, the mother will definitely take care. Father, he will be roaming somewhere else. Okay, he will not be in the group. What about the elephants that are present in the group? Mostly they are males. The smaller one can be, mostly they are females. Smaller one can be male. This can be male. This will be female. And this can be another female. Okay, male will be roaming somewhere else. So as usual, the humans also do that. Which are the following protected areas are located in Kaveri Basin? Where is Kaveri Basin? It is in Karnataka, Tamil Nadu and Kerala, not Andhra Pradesh. So Papi Kondalu is in West Godavari, East Godavari, Khammam region. It is not the option. Two, eliminate two. Two is gone. Three and four are definitely correct. What about one? Here you should take a wild guess. When you take a wild guess, if you stick to C, then it is correct. If you stick to B, then it is wrong. 1, 3, 4, that is Nagarhole, Satyamangalam, Wayanad, Pallar. So Satyamangalam, I have been looking at Satyamangalam for, you know, past 3 years, and it is continuously appearing in UPSC. It seems UPSC has got a different relationship with Satyamangalam Tiger Reserve. This is Kaveri. You can see this is Karnataka, and this is the Kerala, and this is the rest Tamil Nadu, right? So how will you map the reserves? You can see this is the Nilgiri Biosphere Reserve. All this is Nilgiri Biosphere Reserve. What do we have? Satyamangalam. Okay. Then we have the Nagarhole. Somewhere here at the bottom we have Nagarhole. It is not there in the map, but it is here, Nagarhole. Then another one is, what was another one? Wayanad. So Wayanad is also present in the region of the Kaveri Basin. So here Wayanad, can you see Wayanad? I have encircled the three: Wayanad, Satyamangalam, Nagarhole. Earlier he asked one question in the previous year exams. Nilgiri Biosphere Reserves include which of the following wildlife sanctuaries? He quoted 2, 3, like this is Nilgiris. It includes Wayanad, it includes Satyamangalam, it includes Bharatpur, you know, Kolegal, Erode, all these things, right? So remember this wildlife sanctuaries in India. Papi Kondalu, can you see here? Papi Kondalu. There is another Papi Kondalu near this region, near Chennai, but widely considered one is this Papi Kundal. Okay, you might have visited Papi Kundalu. That's a beautiful region. Western Ghats, part of Western Ghats. Sorry, Eastern Ghats, not Western Ghats. Next one is, with reference to India's biodiversity, Ceylon frogmouth, copper smith barbet, grey chinned minuet, white throated red start. Okay, so this question is not for the UPSC, it is for the Indian Forest Service, but we have to answer it. The answer is birds. What are they? They are birds. Birds. This is the frog mouth. Can you see the mouth appears like a frog? Okay, so what is this? This is the grey chinned. Grey chin. Can you see the chin is grey in color? Okay, this is the first one. Copper, Ceylon frog, frog mouth is the frog mouth. Coppersmith barbet is this. This is coppersmith. Okay, copper color. Can you see copper color? The names are, you know, given in a different manner. So this is the white throat. Can you see this throat white in color? All these are birds. Barasingha thrives well on hard ground and exclusively gramivorous. Okay, where do we find Barasingha? Barasingha is actually found in Kanha National Park. How do you know that is there? So let us see. So this is the regions where we have Barasingha, the green one. Okay, so usually most of the Barasinghas are found in the Madhya Pradesh. So this is Barasingha. Count to the singh. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 singhs are there. Singh matlab horn. Not that singh. Yuvraj Singh is not the singh. This is another singh. Where else do you find Barasingha? You can find that. It is in Kanha. This is Kanha. Madhya Pradesh, Kanha. They are also found in the regions which include, you know, Manas, but currently they are not so many in Manas. Okay, some here also they are found. Rest of the things we don't find. We don't find in Madhumalai. Madhumalai must be in south, so that is not the answer. Tal Chappar is not the answer, and it is Kanha. Same question was asked, similar question, but this is about musk deer. Where do we find musk deer? What is musk deer? It looks something like this. Okay, it has got two forks that can be used to eat, you know, grass or whatever it feels like. Where do we find them? Generally, they are found in the Himalayan belt. Okay, now with that, which one do you find in the Himalayan belt? The options. One is Gangotri. Okay. So when you find two, you can eliminate C and D. Okay. Ascot Wildlife Sanctuary and Kishanpur Wildlife Sanctuary. The doubt is between those two. Let us see what is the answer. So you can see here. So this is the region. Okay. So this is the region where we have the musk deer. So option A is the correct, Ascot and Gangotri National Park. They are not reptiles. Okay, so graminivorous, sir. See, graminivorous is very simple. Gramini, divide the word into gramini words, or let us say, we'll take one more example. What is herbivores? Herbi means herbs, that eats the herbs. Gramini means, divide the word, gram vorus, that is grass. Okay, so that eats usually grass. In rural road construction, which of the following is preferred for the environmental, for ensuring environmental sustainability or to reduce carbon footprint? Okay. Copper slag, geotextiles, copper, cold mix, asphalt, okay, are the one which can be used in the construction of, you know, road in rural areas, right? So the answer is only one, sorry, option A, that is 1, 2, 3. See, Portland cement, they can't afford, because cement is derived from the, you know, rocks, which is very costly. So pi is not the option. Wherever you find pi, you can eliminate that. Remaining is 1, 2, 3 and 2, 3, 4. With this, we can estimate that 2, 3 are correct. Okay. And copper slag is used. Option A is the answer. Next one is, consider the following statements. Coal ash contains arsenic, lead, mercury. You might have seen thermal power plants, and thermal power plants usually release lot of coal. Okay, so this is thermal power plant. It is releasing lot of ash, coal ash. It contains arsenic, lead, mercury, correct? Coal fired power plants release sulfur dioxide. I told you it is causing the acid rain, sulfur dioxide. Oxides of nitrogen, NOx. Very simple question in the environment. This is correct. Two is correct. Wherever you don't find two, eliminate that. Okay. High ash content is observed in Indian coal. Why? It is because Indian coal is bituminous type of coal. We don't have anthracite. We have anthracite in Karakoram, but that is not exploitable. Bituminous unnandavalla, we have more ash content. 2 and 3 are correct. Wherever you find 2 and 3, that will be the answer. 2 and 3, 2 and 3. But 1 is also there. And they contain arsenic, lead, mercury. 1 is also correct. So 1, 2, 3 is the option. Biochar. What is the use of biochar in farming? Biochar can be used as a part of growing medium in vertical farming. I want to tell you one thing. When you are visiting Ignite IAS, okay, have you seen a region where, like a region called as HMT, where they were selling the plants, the, you know, the decorative items and the plants were being sold in near HMT, if you remember? Yes. Now, if you have ever taken some pain and visited the plant region here, the nursery, you might find that they are growing the plants in biochar. They don't use the mud. Of course, they use the mud, red soil. But for the plants which are very delicate, they use biochar. What is biochar then? Biochar is a simple mixture which is derived from any waste material which is biodegradable, which is living, and in the absence of oxygen, that is through a process called as pyrolysis, they convert that into a black soil kind of material which is called as biochar, and that can be used in vertical farming, correct? I told you pudina, coriander. When biochar is part of growing medium, it promotes growth of the nitrogen fixing microorganisms, correct? When biochar is part of growing medium, it enables growth medium to retain water for longer time. All of them are correct. Okay, how? You can see this is the biochar. And how will you make biochar? Biochar is made by pyrolysis, by all these materials. Okay, we usually throw the onions which are rotten. We usually throw the grass. Okay, lemongrass, all these materials, corn, but if they are made into pyrolysis, through pyrolysis, they can be converted into biochar. See here, soil conditioner, a large surface area, high CC, high WHC, alkaline pH, right? Retain moisture, lock nutrients, right? So this is the reason why biochar is in use. That's what I told you. Environment and geography can be learned from the nature, the surroundings. Okay? So UPSC, it is stated that everything under the umbrella of, you know, everything under the sky comes under the portion of UPSC, that is syllabus of UPSC. Nobody would have thought that a question would come from the footpath.